I will give you Emma. The countdown timer. Right. Right. The quiz tonight is about movies, TV, music, and celebrities. That's what it's all about. So, the first one is all about, here we go, at the movies. What I'm going to do is I am going to give you the four featured actors or actresses that featured in this film, and you have to just tell me what the film was, right? So, here's one I'm going to bring up now, is the first one. Here we go. We have these four actors and actresses. I think you have to call them actors now, don't you? Because they said they don't want to be pigeonholed. These are four persons. Let's say persons that acted in a film. And all you have to tell me is what was the film all of these four featured in? And there's six questions. Okay, so whenever you're ready, here we go. These are the four main stars of which movie? Chicago, No Reservations, Jerry Maguire, or Entrapment? These are the four main stars of which movie? I could tell you who they are, but I'm not going to because there's another bit of a round where I haven't got a clue who half of them are. This one I do know who they all are. Tay Diggs, Catherine Zeta-Jones, Renee Zellweger, and Richard Gere. And the answer is Chicago. It's Chicago. Jeremy Maguire only had Renee Zellweger in it. No Reservations and Entrapment were both Catherine Zeta-Jones films. So that's why I put them in there. So well done to the five of you that got that right. As we go on to the next one. These four. I can tell you who they are beforehand. They are Jamie Foxx, Kerry Washington, Christoph Waltz, and Leonardo DiCaprio. But what I want to know is, what film do they all come from? Is it Django Unchained, Kill Bill, Jackie Brown, or Once Upon a Time in America? These are the four main stars of which movie? Which movie? I wonder, you know, the countdown theme music, is that copyrighted? Because if I played that every, well, that would soon get annoyed, wouldn't it? You'd hear it 24 times in this quiz. Yeah. No, I don't think I will. The answer is Django Unchained. Once Upon a Time in America was the latest one, I think, from Quentin Tarantino. That was 2019. It did star Leonardo DiCaprio, but all the rest, I don't think. Jackie Brown was 97. K- Kill Bill was 2003. Django Unchained was around 2012. And it had Jimmy Fox in it. But well done to the three of you that got that right. Once Upon a Time... Oh, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. That doesn't matter, though. There was a film called Once Upon a Time in America, so... I don't know why, but Denzel looks quite fat looking in this one, doesn't he? I'm not fat shaming, I'm just saying that it's like they've put his face in one of those like things that you get on an app on a phone. Denzel Washington. Yeah, he looks very puffy. I don't know. Denzel Washington, Michael Rooker, Queen Latifah, and Angelina Jolie. But which movie did they all star in? Was it The Bone Collector, Remembering the Titans, Training Day, or Gone in 60 Seconds? I did a little burp there. I hope you didn't hear it. It's kind of a bit strange, isn't it? Because now that I see that, Denzel was in The Equalizer and The Equalizer 2 movie. And Queen Latifah is the lead equalizer in the new TV show. So there's a link to two of them. But it was The Bone Collector. And three of you got that correct. Gone 60 Seconds only had Angelina Jolie in it. Remembering the Titans and Training Day only had Denzel in it. Michael Rooker, famous for Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer, and he was a guy in The Walking Dead as well. If you're looking to know anything recent he's been in. Four old guys. Clint Eastwood, James Garner, Donald Sutherland, and Tommy Lee Jones. Oh, I was in that too. Yeah. Here we go. These are the four main stars of which movie? In the Line of Fire, Space Cowboys, The Fugitive, or Air Force One? Like, Tommy Lee Jones is probably 20 years younger. Is he? Would he be 20 years younger than Clint Eastwood? Okay, Google. How old is Tommy Lee Jones? Right, he's 75, right? Okay, Google, how old is Clint Eastwood? 91. Jesus. Okay. It was Space Cowboys. There's 16 years of difference between the two. James Garner's dead. I think Donaldson's about 86, I think. Next one. What a tash. I don't think he was. Here we go. Okay, Google, what year did James Garner die? And that film was out in 2000, so he had another 14 years in him. Isn't Google wonderful? These are the four main stars of which movie? Is it The Shootist, The Magnificent Seven, True Grit, or The Great Escape? You got Yul Brynner, Steve McQueen, Charles Bronson, and that other guy. whose name I've fucking forgotten. Oh, he's the English guy. People can tell me. People can shout out. His name escapes me at the minute. I know he's been in other things. Oh, what the fuck do you call him? He's in The Man from U.N.C.L.E. Robert Vaughn, that's it. You know when you sort of get your kind of your head fuzzed? The answer is The Magnificent Seven. All four were in that film or movie. You call that sort of like a Fu Manchu? No, but then you'd have a beard with that, wouldn't you? And because it's six questions, this is the last one of this round. Sir Anthony Hopkins, Winona Ryder, Keanu Reeves, and that last one is Gary Oldman. What's the film? Is it Bram Stoker's Dracula, Frankenstein, Interview with the Vampire, or Vampire in Brooklyn? Should be an easier one, isn't it? Should be. Anytime Gary Oldman comes up, someone will write the thing about, did you know that Gary Oldman is younger than Gary Newman? I was waiting for somebody to say that, but nobody has. Well done, everybody. He didn't fall into the Gary Oldman, Gary Newman trap. The answer is Bram Stoker's Dracula. Four of six people got that right. Mo Slater or Mo and Leila Morse or something. I think her name is. Yeah. Big Mo. So let's look at the scores at the end of that round, shall we? Here we go. And we have Rainbow Blackout is in the lead with 126,228. Fizbin is in second with 63,943. And in third is Ionic Arm with 36,169. Right. Mumalar, you mustn't be said, yes, I want my name mentioned. I believe your quest contestant number four. If not, The next round is called, if you like music, you might know this better, Foreplay. This round is called Foreplay. Don't look at the 5 and the RPM, but it's called Foreplay. I am going to give you 4 artists. They have all had the same title for a song they have sang. What I want to know is, what is the title that links all 4 of these artists? All these songs have reached the top 40. So there's no, oh, this got to number 68 in the charts. You have to grant access, Mumalar, at the side. Sometimes what usually happens is it usually, you know, irons itself out, maybe. So this is the first one. Takes a little while sometimes, yeah. So, I don't know. We have Green Day, Lil Nas X, Dizzy Rascal, and Madonna. They've all released a song with the same title. What I want to know is, what is the title of the song they released? Simples, is it? Is it Holiday, Misery, Montero, or Sorry? All these acts have had the same title of song in the top 40. Can you name the title? Not the same version of the song. It's not like they've all covered the song. They haven't. Same title, different song. The guy on the left on Green Day. Well, I was going to say the guy on the left, the guy, Billy Joe or something. He's definitely dyed his hair as well. Look how black that hair is. The answer is Holiday. Green Day had Holiday in around 2004 from that American Idiot album. Dizzy Rascal had a number one with Holiday, I believe, in about 2010, 2009, that sort of time. Holiday, you know, was from Madonna, 85 and 91. Lil Nas X has a song at the minute, I think, called Holiday. It's only reached 23, but it's still in the top 40. So well done to the three of you that got that right. So, the next one. What a mixture of artists. Look at that. What a lineup. Shakespeare's sister, Ricky Martin, Cheryl, whatever her surname is this week, and Liberace have all had top 40 hits. With the same title of song. What title of song links these four? Your History, Stay, I Don't Care, or Parachute? They're not in the group diversity, no. Did anybody watch that one? What's it called? Behind the Candelabra with Michael Douglas and Matt Damon. Was it like a TV movie and then they released it in the cinema? Something like that? Because I seem to recall it was on TV at the start. Was it HBO made it? So, the answer is, I Don't Care. I Don't Care was the follow-up, I think, to Stay from Shakespeare's Sister. Cheryl Cole's I Don't Care was quite late on in her career, around 2015 or so. Liberace had a top 40 hit with I Don't Care in 1966. And Ricky Martin had a top 20 hit with I Don't Care as well. I don't care. I didn't care, so I selected it. The next one is this. Boom. I'll give you a clue. Well, not give you a clue. I'll tell you who they are. The first person is a artist called Jonas Blue. The second person is Kim Appleby. The third person is Dave Berry. And the fourth act is Little Phil. But it's not, it's Genesis. So, Jonas Blue, Kim Appleby, Dave Berry and Genesis have all had the same song title in the charts. But what was it called? Was it called Fast Car, Mama, Don't Worry or Rise? Kim stones from tinsel from my Christmas tree and stuck it on the top of her hat there. All these had top 40 hits with this song, and the song was Mama. And nobody got it right. Mama. Mama was a number, was it number 19 or something for Kim Appleby? Mama was a song for the other three as well. They all had top 40 hits with Mama. Right. The next one. Right. We have Jesse J, Prince, stroke symbol, Imagine Dragons, and E17. All these have had the same title of song, get into the top 40. But what was the title? Was it If You Ever, Thunder, Let It Rain, or It's All Right? I like the two guys in the E17 at the back going, I think they're just saying to themselves, what are we doing here? We're not even singing. I reckon Roll Sorts has got this one right. I reckon. Thunder. Thunder. Thunder was a hit in 92 for Prince. Thunder was a hit for E17. In 1985, I think. Run Yourself Over. That's Brian Harvey's one. They still held mics and Tall the Pops. So did the woman from Black Box. Doesn't mean that she actually sang. Milli Vanilli held mics and Top of the Pops, did they not? Maybe they didn't because they did a lot of dancing. The next one. Just in case you didn't know, it was the Killers, that's the Killers. We have The Human League, Christina Perry, Rag and Bone Man, and The Killers. What is the title of the song that links all four of these? Is it Fascination, Skin, Human, Mirror Man? All these acts have had the same title of song in the top 40. Can you name the title? I'm not entirely sure what the tattoos are on Rag and Bone Man's face. To me, they look a bit just like, you know, like scribbles I have done on a piece of paper when I'm on the phone to somebody. The answer is... Ooh, five people went for it. Five people were correct. A US number one for Human League in 1986, I believe. Christina Perry, Human as well. Are We Human or Are We Dancer from The Killers? And Rag and Bone Man's biggest hit on his own is Human. I probably think that Giant with Calvin Harris is probably his biggest hit. But as a soloist, Human is his breakout hit. Well done to the five of you that got that right. And the last one, I believe. Yes, it is. The last one. Right. The last one for this round. Just in case you didn't know, it was M&A, by the way. All these acts have had the same title of song in the top 40. Can you name the title? Sing, Collide, Run, Happy. All these acts have had the same title of song in the top 40. Can you name the title? That's M&A, whose biggest hit was I Got a Little Something For You. That one there, right? That's Ashanti, the second person. Leona Lewis in third. And it's Travis on the end. Ashanti. She was big in 2001 to 2002? The answer was Happy. Thought I'd Get You with Run. If people thought the last act was Snow Patrol. It was Happy. Leona got the number two with Happy. I don't even remember how it went. Let's look at the scores, everybody, at the end of round two. Boom. And we see Rainbow Blackout is still in the lead with 153,592, followed by Raw Sorts now at 87,794. Third is Fizzbin with 63,445. And Mummelar has went up to fourth. Right. So, the next round is TV lineups. TV lineups. I have went onto the IMDb website and I have looked up TV shows. And these are the first four actors or actresses that show up for this television show. That usually means they have been in the TV show in the most episodes. That's what usually happens. But some have had shorter episodes than others. So, let's look at our first lineup. Here we go.
Yeah!
Oh, what's that? Is that a sub? It is a sub indeed. Yeah. Apparently I wasn't following you. Hello, David. It's all right. It's fine. Fine. Thanks for the follow, David. Right. So, these four have the most episodes. What a moron. What a dick. How are you, Mr. Bob? I am fine. I'm still drinking my iron brew and I've had a sausage sandwich and that is not a euphemism. Right. So, all four of these were in what show? What is it? Is it The Wire, Boardwalk Empire, True Detective or The Sopranos? Don't tell us what your top 10's going to be, by the way. Because it's a secret. Right, let's see what the answer is. You hold things dear to your heart. The answer is, right. Come on, hold on. It's The Wire, 5 out of 5. Well done. Boom. This round's easier than the other rounds. You won't be on till 9:30 anyway, because Dan usually messes about for half an hour and, you know, starts talking shite. These are four actors from IMDb. No, sorry, the top four actors from IMDb for this TV show. Name the TV show. Office, Endeavour, Sherlock or Elementary. Oh, very unprofessional. Who ever heard of a streamer talking shite? It seems to be working though. Wurzel Gummidge. No, it's not Wurzel Gummidge. It is Una Stubbs, though. It was Sherlock, 7 out of 7. Well done. The next one. Here we go. Yeah. The Blessed. We've got The Blessed. These are the actors and actresses that appeared the most in this show. But what is this show? Is it Ben-Hur, Poldark, The Last Days of Pompeii, or I, Claudius? What am I doing tomorrow? I'm doing bugger all. Well, I'm not doing bugger all, I'm working. I'm working till 5 o'clock, perhaps. And I don't know what the frig I'm doing. I did download Costume Quest 2 on the Xbox, and it's like trick or treating, and but then some people give you sweets and then some people fight you. The answer is I, Claudius, and 6 of you got that correct. It reminds me of the South Park game. Do you remember that one? Oh, the fractured butthole, or the other one, Stick of Truth? Right. It's Will Arnett, Jason Bateman, Michael Cera, and Portia de Rossi. These are the top 4 actors from IMDb for this TV show. Name the TV show. Is it Community, It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, or Arrested Development? I've ran out of Kit Kat Chunkies, because it was my birthday and the other week, and my girlfriend's sister got me a lot of chocolate, even though I told her I don't want chocolate because I'm trying to give up sugar. And then she proceeded to give me 4 Kit Kat Chunkies in white chocolate, 4 Kit Kat Chunkies in ordinary chocolate, 4 Whispers, and 4 Whisper Golds. and an 8-pack of Mr. Kipling's Angel Slices, which are about 95% sugar. The answer is Arrested Development. 7 out of 7 got that right. Well done. Next one. I can't even name you 2 of these people. I know 2 of them. I don't know the first 2. Forgive me. What is the show? These are 4 actors from IMDb for this TV show. Name the TV show. Is it Vigil, Dr. Foster, Safe, or Line of Duty? I've watched Line of Duty, right? But I kind of watched it in an arse about face way. It's like I don't know if anybody else did this, but I started off watching like the series with Thandi Newton in it. And then, I didn't know there was 3 other series of it. But it's very convoluted, and it's like, Patterson Joseph, yeah. Who's the first guy, though? I can't remember his name. It was Vigil. It was the very recent show called Vigil that was set in a submarine. It was on BBC One at 9 o'clock. That's Rose Leslie from Game of Thrones fame, and as the third person, and Saran Jones. But it was Vigil. I'll say it again, Vigil. So well done to the one person that got that right. The one person that watched Vigil. And the last, I think this is the last one of this round, is it? Yes, it is. This is the last one of this round. So these are the top 4 actors from IMDb for this TV show. Name the TV show. Is it Bridgerton, Upstairs, Downstairs, Sanditon, or Downton Abbey? The third person there. I don't know if you know this, but it's probably a common piece of information. But she is the daughter of Sally from Coronation Street. If you didn't know that already. The answer is Bridgerton. Bridgerton. Is it René John Page? Is that his name? Let's look at the scores, everybody, as we go into the final round. Let's see. What have we got? Ooh, Rainbow Blackout is in first. Second is Mumalar now. What is Coronation Street? Coronation Street is about people from Manchester who get into japes. That's Nicola Coughlan at the end. She's more famous for Derry Girls. Royal Sources in third, by the way, with 142,190. So Mumalars went from last to second. As it was, Hilda Ogden is the main character in it. Who has been, well, it's got to be what he called him, isn't it? It's got to be Ken Barlow. It's been in Coronation Street the most episodes, surely. Ken Barlow. As we go on to the last round. And the last round is fourth time lucky. Right. Marriages. Or shall I say divorces. Celebrities like marrying people and divorcing them, don't they? So I'm going to give you four people. Like so. Some guy has married all four of these people. You have to tell me who married all four of these people. Not at the same time, because that would be bigamy. And we don't like bigamy. Not in this house. Here we go. Who has married all four of these people? Nicolas Cage, Emilio Estevez, Val Kilmer, or Charlie Sheen? Who has married all four of these people? I don't think it would be that big of you. Very, very good, David. Very good pun there. So, I couldn't name you the last two. I can name you the first two, Patricia Arquette and Lisa Marie Presley. The other two, I couldn't name you what they were called. It was Nicolas Cage. Yes. Nicolas Cage, I believe, is a super fan of Elvis. So I think that's what made him want to marry Lisa Marie, because he was obsessed with Elvis. Well done to the two people who got that right. Going back in time with these four old men. Don't ask me what they're called. Don't ask me what they're called, because I can't remember their names. But who married four of them? Who married all four of them? It's not Nicolas Cage, no. I should have put Nicolas Cage. Zsa Zsa Gabor, Ivana Trump, Imelda Marcos, or Kim Novak. Who has married all four of these people? I should have fucking put Nicolas Cage in every answer. I'll know for again. What do you say that first guy? He's got a drinker's nose. Or a boxer's nose. Or both. It's slightly phallic in shape, the first guy's nose. Why am I obsessed with penises tonight? I don't know why. We were looking up hairy men calendars earlier on. Thank God I didn't put it on screen because they had their knobs out. It was Zsa Zsa Gabor. George Sanders, yes, is one of them. Correct, yes. I can't name you any of the rest of them. The third one is the last one that married Zsa Zsa. Is she dead now? She might be dead. I think she had 8 husbands. I could have did 2 rounds of her. Right, next one. Right. Who has married all 4 of these people? Is it Randy Quaid, Johnny Lee Miller, Billy Bob Thornton, or Ewan McGregor? I believe these are in order of when he married them. So Angelina was last to be married by him. I couldn't tell you the names of the other ones because I can't remember. She could be 106 now. You never know. There's a 106 year olds about there. The answer is Billy Bob. Billy Bob Thornton. Yes, Johnny Lee Miller did marry Angelina Jolie for a while. I think that was before Billy Bob came about. They were young. Young, dumb, and full of the notion of getting married. But it was not to be. What a motley crew these 4 are. That's not Peter Stringfellow at the end. Right. Who's married all 4 of these people? Is it Carmen Electra, Bret Michaels, Pamela Anderson, or Shannon Doherty? It's not Peter Stringfellow. Do you really want to know? Who did they marry? It is John Peters, I think. Is that his name? Yes, it is. He's an American film producer and former hairdresser. And he's 76. And his former partner was Barbra Streisand. So the marriage certificate, yeah, right. So, but according to this, the marriage certificate on his 5th marriage to actress and model Pamela Anderson, on January the 20th, 2020, was not filed, with the couple separating after 12 days. He says that he was married to her. It is down as being married to him. So yeah. He has also been married 5 times. So, Tommy Lee, she married him in 95, divorced him in 98. Kid Rock, she married 2006, divorced in 2007. Rick Solomon, that's the second guy, married in... This is a strange one, right? No, he's not. Rick Solomon, married in 2007, annulled in 2008. Married in 2014, divorced in 2015. So she's been married twice to that guy, the second guy, Rick Solomon. Gary Oldman was in the last round, I believe. Right. These four chaps. Who's married all four of these chaps? Joan Collins, Audrey Hepburn, Marilyn Monroe, or Elizabeth Taylor? Who has married all four of these people? I think they're in order as well. Of when married. The last guy is the last person she married. The answer is... You only know the second bloke. Aye, the second bloke is Anthony Newley. The answer is Joan Collins. That guy, the first guy, is actually from Northern Ireland. And that was her first marriage, Joan Collins. I didn't know that. He's a teen idol. I think he died fairly... very short. I don't think he was on this world for very long. Maxwell Reed is the first guy. He died 54. He came from Larne in County Antrim. That guy there is Peter Holm, the third guy. He's a former pop singer and Swedish playboy. He became her manager and co-produced two of her television miniseries, Sins and Monte Carlo. And the last one, the last question of the round, is these four. Hilda Ogden. No, it's not Hilda Ogden. Who has married all four of these people? Is it David Foster, Rod Stewart, Neil Diamond, or Billy Joel? And they are in that order. They have married them in that order. So that the last one at the end is the last person he married. Oh God, a burp there. The third one's only 39 years old. Only 39. Can you believe that? The answer's Billy Joel. Yeah, he's trading them in for a younger model. It's like whenever you have a car and hire purchase. Christie Brinkley, the second one. So as he goes on to the next person, they go down in years, about 10 years. I believe. It was Billy Joel. And that is the end of the quiz tonight. And let's look at the final scores and see if Rainbow Blackout has won. He has indeed. He has indeed. Rainbow Blackout is the winner tonight with 343,213. Raw Sorts is in second with 202,641. Ionic Arm is in third with 185,051. Mumalar is in 4th with 164,992. Fizzbin is in 5th with 149,193. Gemma Ingram's in 6th with 57,653. And Contestant 12 is 7th with -25,438. Which means that Jeff, or Rainbow Blackout, gets a go on prize wheel. And the prize wheel tonight is from Blankety Blank 1984. Go on, Les. Tell us what he's won.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are some of the prizes that we found after the fire.
It's tone-up time with this personal massage machine. Luxury food trolley. Get snap happy with this superb camera kit. The latest mini hi-fi cassette radio kit. Knit one, purl one with this home knitting machine. A superb portable colour TV.
How portable is that TV? Look at that. Hope. Okay, small letters. Look how small is that? That's smaller than the bloody tit the Sega Game Gear. The massage machine. No expense spared there, is there? Right. There we go. Oh, you don't see... Right, where did that go? Where did the camera go? Camera. Come on.